Exercise treatment, Mrs. Pugacheva. Let me introduce myself. My name is Natalia Pugacheva. I work in the rehab center of Oganyok, and I'm responsible for physical exercises. Let me tell you about the effectiveness of the comprehensive treatment of idiopathic scoliosis with children. Let me begin with the saying by Leopold Busquets. I like it very much. Knowledge may be an obstacle to understanding when it's not combined with depth perception. Knowledge turns into mind when expressed as a skill. Well, our center is treating from 1600 to 1700 patients per year. Their age is from 4 to 18 years. These are patients with scoliosis, among them with different pathologies, among them 500 per year are with scoliosis. Let me mention teenagers' idiopathic scoliosis, and I will talk about AIS because at present, it's the most frequent diagnosis, idiopathic scoliosis. And I will also mention the right-sided thoracic scoliosis. It's the most common among thoracic scoliosis. And I will tell about patients who have a Cobb angle of 30-45 degrees and about the progressive forms. We all know that it's a 3D deformation of the spine. And this is the pathological vertebral rotation of the horizontal plane and straightening physiological curves in the sagittal plane and the lateral deviation of the spine. Well, as a doctor, I know, and my instructors, it's more important what happens to the body of the patient and what functional disorders may be caused by scoliosis. Take a look. This is the X-ray of the girl, and you can see the main thoracic arch and two arches above and below the main arch, and our body behaves the same as the spine. It's also shifted in three planes following the vertebrae. We see that the pelvis and the lumbar area and the thorax, the shoulders, shoulder girdle moved to the left. You see that the thorax moved to the right. Adam's test shows the back and the front gyrus. And you see the frontal deformation of pelvis as well. We see the sagittal plane that takes place, the straightening of the lumbar lordosis and thoracic kyphosis, and the flat back is obvious. Pay attention to the pelvis, it's getting more vertical. Let me tell you more about the sagittal plane disbalance of our patients, from this group of patients. Sometimes we begin with the flat back, that's the girl who is 10 years old, and sometimes our treatment is finished with flat back. This is a grown-up girl, she's 18. You don't see many frontal deviations, she's stable, but the sagittal profile is very much deformed. She has expressed lordosis of thorax. Well, our children, let me remind you about the normal physiological profile. This is the lordosis of the third lumbar vertebra and kyphosis of thorax. These patients have three kinds of sagittal deviations. First is the flat back. Pelvis is getting vertical, and lumbar lordosis and chest kyphosis is getting straight. Here we see the second option, vertical pelvis, kyphosis, and lordosis. And the third option is when our patients have smoothened lordosis, or lordosis that has shifted its top. The top of the arch is lower at L5 vertebra. These modifications of the lumbar area cause postural low back pain and instability, low back pain.
In our studies, we certainly detect contractures. We see certain limitations to bending in the lumbar area of the spine and contracture of the posterior hip. Also, we see some publications that tell that some braces worsen the flat back situation. Since I've taken thoracic scoliosis, this is also a 3D deformity of the chest as well. As a result, the flexibility of the thorax is decreased, and also the vital capacity is decreased, and the tolerance is decreased. The patients sit in abnormal postures. Look at the left. The child is standing in her typical pose, and on the right she sits in her typical pose, and they even walk in their stereotypes while walking in such postures. Worsens the deformity. So what do we treat when we have this gymnastics and physiotherapy? Certainly the cosmetic defect and the aesthetic deformity. We want prevent the limitations to the mobility of the spine and thorax. Respiratory insufficiency. We want the child to have no back pain. No reduced physical performance, and what is very important for us is the psychosocial state of the patient. Hence, we have the following goals of physiotherapy. We want to achieve cosmetic improvement, improve the quality of life, which is very important for these patients, and also try to prevent respiratory disorders and pain syndrome, and also stop the progression or decrease the deformity. The goals that we set up depend on the treatment period. Depending on what period the patient will be either in mobilization or correction, fixation or stabilization, depends on the main goals and hence afterwards the secondary ones. When I ask my patients, what would you like or what do you expect from therapy, they always, my girls tell me, I want to be beautiful, I want to move freely, and I want to have no pains in the back. Hence, the therapeutic exercises here helps us in comprehensive therapy, conservative therapy of scoliosis. And it's my opinion, not only mine actually, that in treating scoliosis, the specialist has to use only the most effective techniques and methods. And when we have such highly effective methods, no other techniques based on personal preferences is unacceptable. So the objective of our study was to evaluate the effectiveness of the therapeutic exercises programs in conservative, comprehensive treatment of scoliosis. We have selected 114 patients, all girls, average age 13 years, with the Cobb angle 33.5 based on X-ray, right-sided thoracic idiopathic scoliosis, risk of progression 60%, which is very high. The course of treatment was 6 weeks. We developed a special program in our center that includes 6 areas: exercises program, shin or braces, therapeutic massage, therapeutic swimming, procedures of functional bioregulation with the electromyographic feedback, and apparatus therapy or instrumentation therapy. Shin or braces, our patients wore for 18 hours a day, because the first half of the day they attended procedures. Second half of the day, they obligatorily had braces on, and during the night as well, braces on. We manufacture braces at our Ogonek Rehabilitation Center, and we can achieve more than 40% correction in the braces, which is very important. Each patient had 12 sessions of massage. We do manual massage with the elements of point massage. They also had 45 minutes sessions, therapeutic swimming, 15 sessions all in all. In this therapeutic swimming, we try to achieve psychological relaxation, just give them an opportunity to swim, maybe some breathing exercises. They also like aqua aerobics very much, and we use it a lot. This patient, the picture was taken, and this was the function of bioregulation method with the electromyographic feedback. So the correction is carried out with the control of electromyographic parameters. This is an individual procedure, lasts for 30 minutes, 15 sessions per one treatment. Apparatus therapy, magnetic impulse myostimulation, electrophoresis with medications, magnetotherapy and inductotherapy. And then all of my 114 patients were divided into groups depending on the therapeutic exercises we used. 38 patients in the first group received strength exercises program. Second group of 38 patients had undergone postural correction program. Group number 3 received combined programs, a combination of the first two. This is the strength exercises program. Several exercises are shown. It is well described in our publications by Kaptelin and Medifonov. We have modified it a bit, eliminating some exercises which we think are not necessary. These are group exercises, 15 minutes per session, 35 sessions within the course. We have experienced coaches who select the exercises for the patient. You see that the patient herself can correlate the frontal plane. This is a patient with a third grade of scoliosis. The horizontal correction is carried out passively with the help of special pads, which you can see here in the picture. These are also some exercises used within the strength exercises correction program. Second program, postural correction gymnastics. The founders of this program were Katerina Schroth and Dr. Weiss. In 2010, two of our employees went to Germany. We have mastered this program and are using it from 2010. This is an individual program. The program is conducted 60 minutes per day, 1 hour per day, 29 sessions within one treatment course. We have chosen this program because most of all is written about this method, though there are some other methods in the world, and the best results show that this method is really the best practice. The thing that attracted us most of all was that this method has a lot of exercises for sagittal profile correction. This physiologic program is meant to restore physiological lordosis of the lumbar region and try to improve the kyphosis of the thoracic spine. You see this gait, it is very very specific and it is repeated several times. It allows to increase the mobility of the lumbar spine. All our children start from this gait, this walking, with this physiologic program. We teach our patients how to sit, how to stand, what are the best postures in order to correct the sagittal profile. This is the so-called Nuba position, standing and sitting. You see that the lumbar lordosis, we try to actually form it. We dedicate a lot of time to ergonomic principles, how to sit right. We use special chairs, special pads, in order to support the balance of the sagittal profile. Next physiologic program envisages that all the exercises we use next are postural, and we monitor them in order to maintain the lordosis of the lumbar region and not to aggravate the flat back. Then we teach children the 3D exercises. You see the patient here standing in the free position, and we see the deformity. Here she is standing in the correction posture. We teach the patient to use her own muscles, her own body, and thus achieve a 3D auto-correction. They do this themselves. They look into the mirror and they understand how much they can correct this themselves. And you can see sitting now as well, and we see the correction effect of the exercise. Certainly, we are using rotatory asymmetrical breathing in accordance with Katerina Schroll. Starting from the initial sitting position, we try to localize the breathing in the concave parts of the thorax in order for the ribs to be more mobile and thus increase the stretching of the soft tissues in this concave area. The patient is doing this rotationary breathing and tries to hold both the shoulders and the pelvis in these rotatory positions. And then we talk a lot about maintaining correction poses, postures in the course of the day. I teach them such a trick. Maybe I won't improve your arch, won't make it 20 instead of 50, but I will teach you a trick. And if you need, you will be able to stand in such a way that nobody will notice it. Beauty means a lot for our patients, and that's why we dedicate such a lot of time to them, to this. I tell them a lot that you do not have to fix your bad postures. You have to stand in correction. You have to relax in correction, because not all the patients wear braces. But they know how to do these tricks. Look at their backs. If the patient sees such a back in the mirror, and we always use mirrors in our therapy, the motivation of the patients increases. They work with great pleasure because they see the hope for correction. So I tell them, this position is good, this position is bad. And they see this and they have to get used to it. They have to change their stereotypes. And certainly Schrott exercises are used in the same correction postures. The posture itself is already a correction one. And then we start rotation breathing. And we start the stabilization of the posture by way of isometric tension of muscles. All the muscles are tense in the length that is needed. Look, on the left the muscles are elongated, on the right shortened. All the patients are with the third grade of scoliosis. Another exercise. All of them are postural. All of them have induced changes in three planes. We also wanted to see how effective our method would be. In 6 weeks, we conducted this study. We have looked at computer optical topography. We have taken such parameters as lateral curvature in degrees. We have taken the rotation parameter in degrees and also the angle of kyphosis in degrees of the thoracic spine. We have also looked at stabilometry, the foothold coefficient, the distribution of the body weight per feet. We looked at spirometry. We have evaluated the vital capacity and also tests that show strength endurance. That's how computer optical topography results look. The schedule of our study. This is stabilometry, the foothold coefficient. Normally, it is symmetrical and equals 1. In our cases, the body weight was shifted to the right. The right leg and foot provided more support. Spirometry was conducted with the diagnostic Valenta system. The patients, we evaluated their vital capacity in liters. Strength was evaluated with the help of the standard technique. The results are given in the way of a diagram. How the lateral curvature of the spine was changed. First column shows the results before treatment, 35 degrees before treatment, in accordance with the computer optical topography. First group was the strength exercises, second group Katarina Schrott exercises, and third group combination of the first two. And we see that the best results were achieved when the patients worked a lot in the combination group. They had both the postural and the strength correction. We had minus 20 degrees. Then we looked at the rotation component of the deformity. The best results were achieved also when we combine both methods or use the postural correction method. As for thoracic kyphosis, the picture was different. In strength exercises, kyphosis becomes even less or remains the same, but the postural group did not change kyphosis either. So maybe 6 weeks is too little for such long-term deformity. Then we looked at foothold coefficient. Before treatment, the coefficient was 0.86. In postural gymnastics, we had better expressed changes compared to the standard strength technique, strength exercises technique. Spirometry or vital capacity. We had 2.86 before treatment. The norm is 3.5. We increased the vital capacity by using breathing exercises. And we were glad to achieve this. Also, we evaluated the back extensors. Certainly, the increase in the first group, because the target there was strength exercises. In postural gymnastics, the strength did not increase of the extensors. In the third group, there was no worsening.
Our rectus abdominis strength has improved after that power gymnastics, and it doesn't improve in case of posture gymnastics that has different objectives. And let me present the treatment effect. Of course, this was not achieved in 6 weeks. It's a period of 2 years, but nevertheless, we are proud of these results. This girl is my permanent patient. Of course, she does wear Chanel Bryce, and she has no vital capacity of lungs violation. She has a good volume of breathing, and she moves okay. This girl is 7 years old. We are treating her for several years in a row. You can see flat back, yeah, of course. That's why we keep working on that. Some of my children during the exercises, I'd like to ask you a question. What type of scoliosis does this girl have, and what's the degree of scoliosis? How big is the arch? It's a question to the audience. Okay, next slide. This girl has 58 degrees left sided thoracolumbar scoliosis, but when she exercises, she looks great, doesn't she? One more patient. Some of the poses of our exercises, and at the moment her x-ray is like that, and that's her relaxed pose when she's not when she's standing at ease. One more patient. Again, if you look attentively, you'll see that we are getting a hypercorrection during the exercises. And these exercises testify that they do hypercorrection. Of course, it's a static hypercorrection, but it's functional. Well, let me make my conclusions. Physiotherapy, when the patient comes, first of all, the targets should be set. What do we want to achieve? What is our goal? What kind of a patient it is? What kind of scoliosis he has? Next, I want our conclusions to sound as follows. To improve the efficacy of conservative treatment, the treatment exercises should always include postural 3D correction exercises, and rotary breathing should be used as well, especially when the patient is wearing a brace. Sagittal imbalance is the most difficult component for correction of scoliosis, and please pay attention to this problem as well. Both the experts on braces and the specialists of exercises. Rotary component scoliosis is more rigid. Lateral deformation may be corrected in a short time. Well, let me tell you that comprehensive conservative treatment of scoliosis enables to make an obvious correction and to slow down the progress of the disease. Thank you very much for your attention. Thank you very much for excellent presentation. So good that we catched up on time. Any questions to the speaker? You're welcome. It's a very impressive presentation. Well, my question is, your patients, were all your patients wearing braces? Yes, all of them, 100%. Hence is my question. Do you believe that wearing braces is an addition to treatment exercises, or the braces are the leading method and the exercises are just an addition? Auxiliary. Please answer my question, and then I'll think if to ask the second question. I believe if scoliosis is progressing, and when the fast growth is yet ahead of the time, of course braces are the most important thing, and then exercises come next. Hence is my question. When you compare the patients, you show the efficacy of exercises and not of brace treatment, you see? Thus, you are in a dead end regarding the assessment. Please consider it for the future. If we sub-distribute all this information, there's many questions. What are you comparing? How many years of exercises, but how many years of braces? You have great exercises, and you have very well-developed system of exercises. But to be able to make a correct comparison, you have to know about the other kinds of treatment that the patient is getting. Is deformation disappearing due to your exercises or due to the fact that he's wearing braces? And exercises, yes, they're auxiliary. So, braces are never the thing that increase the area of the back. If there was no braces, he would become really a humpback. Thank you very much for your question, Dmitry. Don't say corsetologist or brace specialist. I've studied a lot of literature on